Hello everyone, you are welcome to this live section. All right, so my name is Blessing Okebe and I am your beautiful anchor for this section on Women Will Abba. So the time is 11 a.m. on the dot, and today the beautiful and delectable Joy Nealo will be coming live on our Instagram page today to teach us the effective or the branding strategies for business success. All right, so first of all, like you know, my name is Blessing Okebe and I'm a digital marketer and a proud member of the Google Women Will team. So what is Google Women Will all about? Okay, Google Women Will is a Grow with Google program, that is focused on equipping women. Okay, we are focused on providing women with the right resources, the right exposure, the right communities for their business and for their personal success. We do this through our events, our physical events, and our live sessions like the one you are viewing today. All right, so I can see that Joy Nealo has joined us. Welcome, ma'am. Please send a request to join the live section. Send a request to join us. So who is Joy Nealo? Who is she? I'm so excited to be in this live section because I look forward to all the value she's going to bring, and knowing her capacity, I expect nothing less. Okay, so Joy Nealo is a digital media consultant and she's the founder of Beacon Experience. And through this company, through her company, she helps both business brands and personal brands build visibility, build impact, build influence, and of course, make money leveraging on digital media. Beacon Experience has a lot of sub-companies inside it. It is made up of Straight From School Initiative, which is SFSI. She is also made up of Beacon Digital and Beacon Emerging Leaders Award, which is focused on bringing the spotlight on emerging leaders of different industries. All right, so that is what Beacon Experience is all about, and this is who Joy Nealo is. In today's section, she will be teaching us branding strategies for business success. So if you are a business owner here or you're intending to start any business, this section is for you. What you just have to do is to get your writing materials, to get your pen, to get your book, and of course share this link and invite your friends who are business owners as well, because trust me, you will be getting loads and loads of insights today. So I'll be bringing Joy Nealo right on stage now, and if you're joining us, tell us what business you do, what do you do as a business. So just tell us. We can as well network with each other as a section, before the session, right? So, Ekelechi, what do you do? Where is your location? Who knows? Your customer may be on this live section with us. And please, guys, tell me if you can hear me so I don't end up talking to myself. All right, tell me if you can hear me. Sorry, I'm trying to pin this. Abba people, how are you? Okay, I think Joy has some network issues and we will be rectifying that soon. Oh,
can you hear me?
Oh, yes, I can hear you now. Good morning.
You've been, you're looking so beautiful today.
thank you. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yes, I can.
Okay, that's it.
Given my end.
Hi, Kelechi.
So I've given a little but official bio about you. So I want you to tell us in your own words who Joy Emeyalu is. So we want to hear from you.
Okay, so good morning, everyone. My name is Joy Emeyalu. I like to call myself a digital media consultant as well. I run a digital media company called Beacon Experience. And, you know, what we basically do is to find different means. Our various expressions. We have the Beacon Digital, basically where we offer digital solutions, website design, content strategy, and all these things. And we have an expression where we empower Nigerian or African graduates. So it's called Straight From School Initiative. And then we have the awards where we recognize individuals who are impacting in their various industries. And we're currently working on our first digital media publication, which is called More.
A woman, right?
Okay, so yeah, that's what it is in a nutshell.
Okay, so you're one of the women doing amazing things. When I saw the name of your company, which is Beacon Experience, I was curious because, you know, this is not a really, it's an unusual name. So can you tell us the inspiration behind?
The name Beacon Experience. So first of all, there are two different words, Beacon and then Experience. So the part of the name that is called Beacon, which is something that I stand for, being a light wherever I find myself, okay? Mm. I try to ensure that that people remember me when I leave a particular, that's like my mantra. So there's no way I will, even if it's online, even if it's physical, there's no way I'll be somewhere and you won't remember that girl.
Joy. Yeah.
That's always what I, then the other part, experience, of course, you experience me or you experience my brand, you know, so the whole name it simply means experiencing life. That's what it means. So whether you come across me or my brand virtually or physically, you are definitely going to say something, and it has to be something positive. You have no choice.
Okay, that satisfies my curiosity because I've been thinking, what does Beacon mean? What does Beacon mean? Thank you so much for letting us know. Okay, just before we dive into the meat of the matter, please, if you're just joining us, I would love you to get your writing materials because Joy is here to blow our minds, trust me. So get your writing materials, and if you have any questions, use the comments. I'll write them down as soon as I see them, and once she's done, I would ask the questions. Okay. Matter today. Tell us about your journey into the digital world. Okay, tell us your journey into digital media. Is this something you were passionate about right from the beginning? So, what prompted you to go into digital marketing and digital media?
Okay, so what prompted me to go into this? So, first of all, I must say that I have a background in media and communication. So, when I was in the university, all what up was radio, TV, magazine, and all those things, right? And, I remember one time, one of our professors, you know, was like, say to the part of media that you like to practice. Honestly, that day, I was very confused. I remember my fellow classmates writing advertising, PR, radio, TV, you know, but I was like, I don't get it, like, I don't, what is PR, what is advertising? Like, I just did not, for some reason, I didn't know. In fact, I think I wrote, I don't think I wrote that day, but I just wrote, right? You get it. So on leaving school, I didn't even know what I was still going to do, you know. And right from day one, I've always known myself to be a media girl. Right from day one. Right from the day I knew something. And of course, it came from my family background. So you will find comedians, people with TV. My father made me read newspapers to him. You know, my uncle and my dad would always turn on the TV every Saturday morning and call me and my sister. Then it was just two of us. and ask us to join them in exercising. I watched Agbani Darego live when she was crowned Miss World. So all of these things. And then I kept listening to radio, Cool FM, as in everything they as they were talking on radio, I'll be imagining stuff. So leaving school, I served in Osun State, and that was where I met someone who, and now he didn't ask me to come and sit down and learn what I design. No. He just, he was always building. I found this boring then. He was always building, but then I was always with him, like, for straight 1 year, you know, and that goes to tell you that your environment matters. Even if you feel like you're not actively learning that thing, subconsciously, you know, and that's why I love people who say, this girl, they one kind, but that's what should they do? You know, if he enter me, but you're in the same environment with the person, you are joking. Subconsciously, ego enter your body. It does not need any permission from you. It does not need any permission from you. And that's exactly what happened to me with Website Design. So when I came to Lagos, I realized that, okay, that time, if you were in Lagos around 2014, 2015, you know, the buzzword then, digital marketing is no longer a buzzword now. The buzzword then was content, digital marketing, and all those things, you know. So I wanted to find out what it was. But then I just said, okay, I know how to build one. And give it to me, I'll build. And I think my gender also plays a role. Like, oh, she's female and she can build a website. Oh, wow, okay, build it for us. And then I gave it to them. I collected the job, and I just wanted to give it to my friend that taught me how to build websites. He built it and gave me 20K. I think he did that for two times. And then one day I asked myself, wait, 20K? No. The pie has to be bigger. What am I doing? You know, so the next job I got, I sat down, I used YouTube, everything I remembered him doing then, started playing in my head. I started learning. The one, anyway, I faced confusion, you know, I'll call him. And he was so kind, you know, to teach me and put me through. So let me just say that was how the whole thing started. For the past 10 years, for the last 10 years, all I've been doing basically the waters, you know, preparing myself for the next decade, like, okay, now that I know what it is I want to do, what do I want to build, you know? And I'm very, if you've known me since, you know, I know how to test. Today I'm doing this, tomorrow I'm doing that, next tomorrow I'm doing that, you know? I just kept testing different aspects. Just so that, like now, I know the aspects of media that I will not put my hands in because it's not like, I think it's not profitable. It just does not suit my personality, right? So something that I will find boring. I won't be able to deliver my best. Why there are other parts of media that comes to me naturally? I will close, even when I'm sleeping, I'll deliver, right? And that came from testing the waters. No coach would have helped me to find that out. Nobody would have helped me to figure that out. I only had to do that by testing the waters. So right now, all we are doing at Beacon Experience now is focusing on the future, knowing the things that we already know what works. So now we know where we're headed. So that's basically the short advertising that I don't even know what I wrote, but hallelujah, not follow my lecturers way.
Oh, that's so amazing. And I think that's the same story with a lot of people, especially women who enter into tech. You see a woman who is into tech and you're like, just because it's a woman, you're in wonder quotes. Okay, because men are more found in digital marketing tech than ladies. But I think now we are getting more and more ladies into tech, into being interested in tech. All right. So, okay. So just before you go into what you have for us today, guys, please, if you're with us in the comments, please, we need the comments to be as engaging as possible. All right. So once as she's talking, any points that hits you, please use the comments and tell us about it. Use emojis. Let's not make this place silent. If you have any questions to ask, leave your comments and I will attend to them. So today we are talking about branding strategies for business success. And in the next few minutes, Joy Negalu is going to be teaching us on the exact same thing. So Joy, the floor is open to you.
All right. Thank you so much, Women Will Abba. Thank you so much, Liza King. Thank you, Blessing Okere, for having me here today. So at that last night, I didn't even know it was going to happen on Instagram, you know. It was this morning I checked, and I saw that they put the Instagram live. They almost hit myself on the head to say, this girl, attention for details. So I had actually prepared a slide, but when I got the info that it was going to be Instagram live, I have to just put everything here. So you're going to see me looking down and up, okay? And I'll try to bring it up. So just in case, so I just want to be able to talk about something before we go right into it. So whenever you hear people talk about... That's true, okay? I've heard pretense, I've heard unnecessary packaging, and I've heard all sorts, all right? I'm sorry if you came across somebody who used personal branding on you and did not deliver. I am very, very, very sorry. That is not the goal of personal branding, okay? So personal branding is just a way of defining yourself, you know, telling people who you are, what you stand for, what you do, right? Getting them to understand you, to like you, to trust you. That is what personal branding is. And really, everybody has a brand. Every person in this world has a brand, okay? So I'm so sorry if anybody has, you know, used the whole strategy of personal brand on you and maybe they scammed you at the end of everything. No vex, okay? So that's why you and I, we are here. We can do better. We'll learn better and also keep teaching people about this thing. But whether you are in the workplace, whether you are an entrepreneur, you know, whether you are a boss, you need a personal brand. There's personal branding in the workplace. There's personal branding as an entrepreneur. There's personal branding as an employee. You need it. It works. Okay? It works. And it is not even by, yes, Kelechi, thank you. It is not by the way you dress. It is just a tiny part of it, you know. A large chunk of your personal brand is actually your integrity, you know, your reputation. That is what your personal brand is all about. So I'm just going to go right into it because I was told I have like 30 minutes to go through this. And if we start from today to tomorrow, we may not finish, okay? So first thing about your personal brand is mindset. Mindset. Why do you want to build a personal brand? Why do you think a personal brand is for you? Or some of you even know that you are very good at what you do, right? But you don't want to package yourself just because you feel like you know rich, all right? Permit me here. I'm Christian, so permit me here. There is a verse in the Bible that I always use, all right, to push this whole personal branding thing. And I tell people, see, it is a huge sin if you have a gift and you're keeping it to yourself. It is a huge sin, okay? You can take your story from the parable of the servants, you know, the ones that they gave money, and one of them went to bury it. You can take your example from there, all right? But then I want to take my own lesson from Matthew chapter 5 from verse 14 to 16. And I'm going to read it here. It says, you are the light of the world. You are the light of the world. It's like walking into your room and you on the light, you know. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, all right? Yes. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, now this is where the command comes in. Let your light shine before others. If you are here and you are still forming, I'm shy. People will say, did you see that God did not talk about anything about any, what is not say, go and know if Emeka has on the gem. Go and know if they fix the wire to switch on the light. He's not telling you that. So he commanded you. He said, in the same way, let your light shine before others, you know, and not just for you. He said, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. So because of your gift, people are meant to be drawn to God. Because of your gift, people are meant to give glory to God. For example, if your gift is that maybe you know how to help people double their income very well, right? So imagine helping someone to double their income so well, and they're able to solve their family problems. You know, they're able to pay their school fees and all those things. They may be telling you, thank you so much for helping me. But hey, they're actually giving glory to God. They are excited. Indirectly, you have solved a problem through the gift God has given to you. Guys, this is not a joke. And this is the mindset I want you to have about your personal brand, that you are light, okay? You've been commanded to go out to the world and shine so that glory will be given unto God, all right? That is number one, mindset. Nobody, you shouldn't be saying, oh, but plenty of people are already doing it now. What will I be doing there? Excuse me, ma'am. Excuse me, sir. We are different people, okay? Whether we are 100 of us doing the same thing, right? Our expressions can never, ever be the same. And that's why you see people creating events almost around the same theme, right? But the expressions are different because everybody's bringing in their own juice, their own uniqueness, their own personality, their own gift into it. It can never, for the love of God, be the same. All right? Please. Have a good mindset. That's number one. Number two is to map out who you are. Who are you really? All right? Who are you? Because you cannot have a scammer behavior. You cannot have a bad attitude. And it will be hungering you to build a personal brand. That's like a quick recipe to kill yourself. Okay? Who are you? You need to keep asking yourself that question. Even Jesus asked. You know, Jesus asked. Some of you don't even know what you are known for. Some of you think you're known for A, whereas the public know you for Z. So you need to know who you are, really. All right? If you don't know how to go about this, a simple exercise I always tell my community is to ask your friends. Ask your friends. See, guys, I'm even a living example. Because I am somebody who has a lot of skills in the digital space, podcasting, video editing, video this one, and all those things, right? I didn't even come up with the name Digital Media Queen. I remember the person who said this vividly, Victor Onyekere, my friend. He was the one that came with the whole thing of Digital Media Queen. And I'm like, this makes sense. So it encompasses everything. You know, instead of the social media strategist. If you know me before, I used to say I'm a social media strategist. It was when Victor Onyekere, my friend, said saying Digital Media Queen. And then he just gave me a scope. You know how they say, now you know they rate yourself. That was my case. You know, I was only seeing myself as a social media strategist. I was not rating myself. Until people started calling me Digital Media Queen, and I'm like, oh, okay. People are rating me right here, right? And that was when I plugged into the whole thing, right? So you need to keep asking yourself who you are. If you have no idea, please interview 10 of your friends, okay? What do you think I'm good at? Okay, if you're asked to describe me, right? If you're asked to describe me, you know, who would you say I am? You need to ask. If Jesus could even ask, you know, his disciples, who do men say I am? Then who are you, please? You need to start asking. All right? Ask people for clarity's sake so that you'll not be calling yourself a baker when people are seeing you as somebody that owns one empire. You'll not be calling yourself baker, please. Okay? Let's not use our own hands to destroy our destiny. Okay? So moving on. And, even in building, in figuring out who you are, right, there are different things that come to play. Some of you are naturally funny, right? Some of you, when people come across you, they think you're a snob, not knowing that you're actually sweet on the inside. And you know, some of you can relate to this thing. All of these tiny things matter. All these traits, they matter a whole lot in building your personal brand, okay? They matter a whole lot because you can't be seen as someone who is funny and then online you're coming to give us that rigid personality. No, that will not work. The essence of personal branding is to be yourself. Yeah. That's the essence of personal branding. You can't be another person. All right. So you can actually be a thought leader who is funny, who injects humor into what they do and still pass your message without being seen as a newsman or without being seen as a comedian, all right? You don't need to be tagged a comedian. You can actually pass your message with, you know, a touch of humor And you won't be called. A very good friend of mine who does this is Chidinma Madokoli. If you know her, she's a storyteller. She tells her stories and she injects humor in it, but nobody has ever come to call her a comedian. Okay? So you need to find out who you really are. All of these things put together will help you, will give you an idea of how to really position yourself. Then the next thing you have to do is to set your values. Guys, set your values, though, because the market is rugged. I will not even lie. The market is rugged, right? There's a whole lot of things to say here, right? But I'm just going to keep it small. I'm going to try to keep it small, right? Set your values. What will you be found doing? When people are not watching you, who are you? Are you the one that comes out to say, oh no, don't take bribes? But when you're inside your car, you're taking and giving. You are the chief distributor of bribes. Are you the person? You know? Who, I mean, what are your values? What are the things that you will not be found doing? And what are the things that you'll be found doing? What sort of character are you building? You need to ask yourself these questions. Very, very, very important, okay? Are you the one who injects excellence into what they do? Are you the one who is innovative? Are you the one who responds on time? You know, all of all these things matter. Do you keep your word? Are you the one that says, buy my book for 60K. I'm going to give you this bonus. When people buy the book, you will go missing. Are you that type of person? You need to be able to set your values. It is very, 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 very important, okay? Are you the one that goes around, maybe sleeping around for jobs? I want to believe we don't have, I'm not condemning them, but we know that we're not.
We don't have them here.
All right? Are you the one that tries to manipulate people? Please, check yourself. Check your inner heart. You're the only one that can tell yourself the truth. Please. Check yourself, your left heart, your right heart, atricus vein, check everywhere to be sure that good values still remain inside that place, okay? Because that's what matters in the long run. And truth be told, you can't hide for long. You know how they say, breeze go blow, fine ash go open. That is how it always is. One day, you will be caught. So you need to be able to check yourself and say, this is who I am. This is how I'm setting myself. This is the standard. I am not going below this. It is important that you set those things before you start going for your personal brand journey, please, all right? Then number four, identify your strengths and your passion, please. Build your personal brand around your strengths, all right? Don't say, let me say for example now, you know that, I mean, you are very, 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 very good at, let me say, helping people triple their income. Right? But instead of you to build a personal brand around that, you are saying you want to do HR. Hello, how are you? Is it that you like to suffer? Please, build your strength around, build your personal brand around your strength and your passion. Something that you can do in your sleep, okay? Something that you'll be proud to promote. You'll be proud to promote something that, you know, is associated with your business or your job. You know, something that you will not be confused. Some people, because of this confusion, they have Instagram page for cooking, Instagram page for social media, helping people to put their income. They have Instagram page. Don't suffer yourself. You don't need to do that. Pick one or two. Some people even have four, but finally they found a way to tie all of them together. Okay? They found a way to tie all of them together. So I'm going to give you an example. There is somebody I know, she's a mom. Number one, she's a mom. And she sells, is it veggies or so, right? She sells all these veggies. So whenever you go on her social media page, you're going to see her talking about motherhood, talking about helping, you know, growing your children and what children like and don't like, you know, their food type and all of all those. And then she talks about those veggies, the importance. Now, it makes sense to me because obviously, she's targeting mothers. Okay, she's targeting mothers. So, it is okay for her to talk about motherhood, children as the side gist and still find a way to tie it to her veggies that she's selling. Guys, please, do you understand this? Let me know in the comments. Do you understand this? Okay? Don't go and kill yourself opening page for this one. Opening as I am now, I can decide to talk about everything I do on my personal page because they're all tied together. It's all media. It's all digital media. Okay? Account for that one, and you're killing yourself. All right, so please ensure that you build your strength, your personal brand around your strength and your passion. All right, then choose a subject matter and become an expert in it. Okay, choose a subject matter and become an expert in it. Okay. If you want to talk about photography, KJ photography, talk about photography, light, natural light, camera types, lens, all those things, talk about them, right? Because photography is the subject matter that you have chosen, okay? If you say you want to talk about food, good for you. You can even, some people even narrow it down, okay, to maybe food for children. I have a friend who sells toys. You know, and she talks about children playing, talks about the kind of toys that children can use to play. I mean, so I already know that everything I see is toy. I've already bookmarked her page for when the Lord gives us a husband and we give birth to our children, we are going to go there to select a toy. All right?
Amen.
So it's very, very important. Choose a subject matter and become an expert in it. Now, just because you're talking about photography, for example, doesn't mean you can't talk about any other thing, okay? So it can be 80% of your content can be photography, while the remaining 20 can just, you know, be around other things that maybe you like, but don't let it, for example, now maybe you can talk about somebody that her boyfriend cheated on her. That will not be your topic. People start asking, are you not a relationship expert? Okay, so 20%, that is it only. You forget it. 80% photography. Some people are even so stingy with their subject matter. It has to be that one thing alone. Whichever one works for you, but just make sure that your subject matter is the highest, number one. All right?
Yeah.
Then choose key social media platforms. Hey, can we have Nigerians here? Choose key social media platforms. I know that they say yes, be everywhere as a personal brand, blah, blah, blah. Wahala for who no get strength, though. Because I don't know how you intend to share yourself among all the social media platforms. I mean, there's YouTube, there's LinkedIn, there is Instagram, there is Facebook, and all of these things, right? So how do you really want to pour yourself in all of these social media platforms? Choose the key ones. For example, photography. By default, photography, Instagram. I don't know where else you want to be. Okay? I don't know where else you want to be. By default, okay? Instagram. Then maybe you want to do, if you do like video classes for photography, you may want to maybe add YouTube to it. Where you do maybe videos showing people how to clean their lens, you know, set their lights, and all those things, right? Then for food, Instagram already, you know. I think Twitter, almost every brand can be on Twitter because really, Twitter is just, I don't know. I saw somebody saying Twitter is for activism and all those things. If you want to go viral, just go on Twitter. You know, just make sure that you go viral for the right reasons. My hand is not
exactly.
You go and do another thing. You know, so please choose at least one or two social media platforms and own it, okay? Own it. I used to be on Facebook, but when I figured that, okay, I think I've done well for myself on Facebook and looking at, you know, where I was headed, my target audience, they were no longer on Facebook. I decided to just, you know, go somewhere else. So right now, you'll find me more on LinkedIn, okay? You'll find me more on LinkedIn and on Twitter. Even Instagram, I went back on Instagram a bit, all right? So choose the one that works for you, all right? Choose the one that works for you, the one that will not drain you, you know, please. Then the seventh one is consistently share content, okay, and deliver value. That is exactly how you become an expert, a thought leader, by sharing content, okay? Nobody becomes a leader by keeping quiet, no, okay? You keep talking and talking and talking and talking about that topic, and people, your name becomes synonymous with that subject matter. So it's very, very important that you share content and share it consistently. Share valuable content, so please, okay? And even if you're commenting on anybody's post, please avoid the trap of deep words. Yeah, you've imparted my life, sir. Thank you so much, sir. I needed this today, sir. Please, just stop that. If you want to communicate, communicate like a leader. Share your thoughts on that thing and go. All right, share your view on that thing and go, please. All right, so share it, share consistently and deliver value. All right, then you need to learn how to build a community. Build a community. That is actually what makes you a leader, because a leader is someone who actually is responsible for other people directly or indirectly. So you need to build a community, a tribe, people that understand your language, okay? People that you also understand them, right? So you can do this through your email list. You can do this through maybe a WhatsApp group. If you are not, for someone like me, I'm very careful about my personal space. So you may want to do like, maybe if you're like me, you may want to do like an email list or maybe a Facebook group. Personally, a Facebook group is tiring, I'm not going to lie. I've tried it so many times and it did not work. So I found
I can
that email
that.
List worked for me. So I'm just with my email list, deadly, I beg. All right? So build your email list, create a Facebook group if it works for you. I hear there's an Instagram group as well. Good luck to you if that works for you. You can do like a WhatsApp group or a Telegram group if that works for you as well, okay? But ensure that you have people in a group, okay? People in a space virtually where you communicate with them consistently. You nurture them until they get used to your lingua, your personality, the way you talk, the way you vibe, you know, such that even when you sell to them, they are excited to buy from you, okay? And then you need to begin to offer solutions. Begin to offer solutions, okay? You can do this in two ways, either free or paid. But that all is not a good thing. It has to be free and paid, okay? Free and paid. unless maybe your calling is to, I don't know, maybe you're like the Mother Teresa of our time, and that's fine, all right? But then you can do free and paid. So you give, I don't know if you heard of this saying, dab, 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 hook, right? So where you give, and then you sell to them, okay? Very, very important. And the reason I'm always about selling to your community is for you to train them, okay? Because so many people, your community does not buy from you because you've already trained them not to buy, okay? I'm going to give you an example. There was this lady one time I met, and she was complaining to me that her community does not buy from her, cockney. And honestly, at that point, I didn't even know what to say or what to help her with or something. Until I heard that gist from one of our community members, you know, that she used to say she cannot spend anyhow money buying coffee. And she actually says this thing in front of her community members, okay? This course is too expensive. I cannot buy it, so please, the people should be careful with your money, this and that and that. And then she goes ahead to now create a course, and she sells to them, and they don't buy.
what does she expect?
My goodness. Okay, so sometimes you are the reason your child is not buying from you because you've trained them. Sometimes you don't sell to them. A lot of times you don't sell to them. So They're already used to, okay, since she's Mama Teresa, let's stay here. She, if she sells to us, we'll know that this is not the Mama Teresa vibe. We are going to wait for the Mama Teresa vibe to come out. She's going to offer it for free. You know, she's going to give us discounts. You know, and all about those things that they normally do. So, because of that, they will not buy from you. All right? Then, some of you, you keep offering them 1K, 2 weeks WhatsApp masterclass for 1K. And then the day you now offer them a program of 200K. Bing! Everywhere will be quiet. Nobody will say anything. From 1K. So they're from, and that's all of these things matter. Okay? All of these things matter a whole lot. They matter a whole lot. Some people, I don't know, even your pricing even helps people to perceive your positioning. Your pricing helps people to perceive your positioning, okay? You're going to do 1K, 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 1K. Before you know it, the market by themselves will just carry you and position you here, okay? So that same thing that you're offering them for 1K, somebody will go and do it for 100K, and they will go and pay for it. And then you'll be wondering, what did I do to myself? Okay, so you need to start. See, I told somebody, one of my members, I told them, see, make it expensive as long as you know that there's value in this thing and that they're going to get results from it. Because if you know that there's no value in it, my hand is not there. But if you know that there's value in it and that they're going to enjoy, they're going to get results, okay? Price it. If nobody buys it, no problem. Close it and relaunch it again. They will wake up. They will wake up to it. Okay? Keep giving them value. As the day you want to open the course again, resell it again. They will one day, they will open it. They will take it. No, they do 1K, they do 350. No. Okay? Don't be letting them know that you're hungry. All those WhatsApp masterclass things, please shift away from it. So I'm just going to do like a quick rundown. My time is already getting close, Abby. Yeah. Okay, let me just do like a quick rundown, all right, of things that you need to important things that you need to know. All right. So first of all, building a personal brand demands discipline. Guys, it demands discipline. The moment you say that you want to put yourself out there, let me tell you, there are some things that you are not allowed to be doing again, okay? And some things that you cannot do, all right? And some other, also some things that you need to begin to do, right? Your lifestyle may change. Your lifestyle may need to change, all right? So you need to understand that it requires discipline. Then people trust people. It's not by doing fine logo and then putting everywhere, red and yellow everywhere for us to see that your branding is no baby. People trust people. It is you, not the logo we they buy. Now you we they buy, okay? Now you we won't see. So we need to know that you are the real deal, all right? Then perception is important. Hey, my people, perception is important. Imagine I'm not coming with this my beautiful makeup and my beautiful hair. You don't be wondering who is this or market woman that is talking to us about something. What does she even know? Right? So please, perception is important because it is only God that sees the inside. Me, I'm man. I'm gonna judge you from your looks. Yes, I'm saying this. I'm gonna judge you. I'm gonna look at your shoe. I'm gonna look at your hair, your earrings, your makeup. I'm gonna look at all of all those things and be like, damn, she's good. She's gonna get my money. But Mama, if you look like one wannabe somewhere, sorry, or yeah, it's your case, so, then attention is your currency. You need to know how to hack attention, guys. I'm not saying go and be naked on Instagram or because you're looking for attention. No. Or go and lie. Or go and plan one thing, okay? No. I'm only saying you have to learn the art of giving attention. Let me tell you what works and what I've seen that works. See, guys. Sure, you see good photography. I'm not going to say this again because some people are going to use it the other way around. But let me leave it.
No, then continue.
Have a PR plan. Have a PR plan. Guys, we have three kinds of media. We have the earned media, the owned media, and the paid media, okay? You have to be able to leverage these three kinds of media, not one, not two, all three, okay? Even if you have to organize an event for people to know about you, events are like my own personal PR hack. I love organizing events, okay? They're like my own personal PR plan hack, okay? You also have to find out ways to join communities, all right? Where you can get access to media guys, all right? Guys, even a platform like Bella Niger, you can contribute a lot. You cannot say you're a personal brand, you're a thought leader, we never even see you for Bella Niger, we never see you for Cool FM, we never see you for TV, we never see you anywhere. Eh? Even Jay Joro never even feature you. So what are you now doing with yourself? It is left for you to push yourself. Push at your podcast, your YouTube, your website. Do you have all these things? It is important. Then create your digital assets, of course, owned media, that's what I'm talking about. Tell your story, please. Tell, okay? Story. How did you get into this thing? Okay? What led you to do this thing? Okay, please. You need to be able to tell your story. Then remember that it takes 1 second. It takes 1 second to destroy your reputation. Guys, it takes 1 second to destroy your reputation. So you have to be very careful where you are, who you are seen with, what you do, what you say. All these things matter. Okay, when somebody asks you a question, if you feel like you don't have all of the answers, you do not need to reply immediately, my love. You do not need to just go and think about it and come back, okay? That's your right, and you need to exercise it. Then consistently invest in yourself. You can't be a personal brand with the knowledge of 1986. No, okay? Digital media now, as we know, it is evolving. It's not only website design, social media management. No, we are now beginning to see different parts of digital media, emerging technologies coming in. How do you intend to learn these things? You have to invest in yourself. Pay the price, so don't be stingy to your destiny, please. Pay the price. Then be authentic. You have to be authentic, okay, please. We don't want breeze to blow and we don't want to see no foul ash. Please, be authentic to yourself so that your followers will love you and you're also going to enjoy the relationship that will come, okay, from your community members loving you and from you loving them, all right? It's very important. And then my last point is going to be you always have to have a view. That is why you are a thought leader. People cannot be asking you questions and you can be saying no. You always have to see things, you know, left, right, you know, see and say, okay, this is what I think. And all of all those things, okay? A case to be yesterday, Mary was trending on Twitter, right? And Mary talked to somebody that was to give her job anyhow. And a lot of people kept on talking plenty. And me, I gave my own points, okay? Mary is naturally rude. That is my own. She's naturally rude. Because I see no reason, even if person comes to your door to knock, I see no reason why you have to answer somebody in that manner, all right? So please always have a unique point of view. That is exactly what makes you a thought leader. People always want to hear your opinion as regards a certain situation. And don't fall for the trap. It's not every matter that you have to talk about, because sometimes they're going to come to you and be like, Sama, what do you think about this? You've not said that. Your answer should be, my love, my point, what I think about it is that we should all face our front and mind our business. Thank you so much.
Guys, please, guys, this, I don't even know the words to describe what the bomb that Joy has just given us right now. Please, let's use the comments. How can you describe this section? Man, thank you so, 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 so much for that, Joy. Thank you. Like, I really, I'm sure everybody here, everybody's here, everybody's head here is blowing out. All right, so thank you so much for that section. In the next few minutes, I will ask a few questions. I think we have just a few minutes to round up, so I'll ask a few questions in the next few minutes. Guys, if you have any question, please use the comments and ask your question. I'll get them across to her as soon as possible. So I really love the way you started on what personal branding is all about. You started with mindset, because a lot of people think that personal branding is all about your fine clothes, the pictures you put on Instagram, you go to studio, take five pictures, and you're using it to post every day. So thank you so much. And I really love the Bible reference you gave to personal branding. You are the light of the world. Shine. You know, let's not just go there. But thank you so much for really elaborating on that. So you talked about building on your strengths and what you are passionate about. Now, I want to ask the same question. What if your strength isn't what you are passionate about? Okay, so maybe you know how to do something really well. You have results in it, but you're just doing it for the money. Maybe as a career, you're just doing it for the money, but you're not really passionate about this. In that situation, what do you do? And maybe what you're passionate about isn't what that can give you money or something you don't really have results in. What do you do in that situation?
Okay, so some people have like short-term goals and some people have long-term goals. So there's nothing wrong if you decide to build a personal brand around that thing that is bringing you money now. Okay, because you can always evolve, all right? When I started, I didn't start with, I plan to build a digital media company. No, I did not start with that. Nobody knew that was my plan. I actually had it as, by 2019, 2020, I will begin to talk about my digital media company, you know? But what did I do? I needed to get known first, all right? I needed people to know my name. I needed people to understand me first. And so I started building around the things I was doing there, social media management. I don't do social media management anymore, right? But then people knew me for that. I built a brand around that because that was what was bringing up. See, what is the essence of being a broke personal brand? Doesn't make any sense, because personal brand is not even cheap. That is the truth. It is not cheap, all right? You have to find your way to ensure that you have money coming in to be able to put some things right. To be able to, I mean, maybe not everything, but to put like the most important things, okay, put them in place, all right? So for me at that time, using myself as an example, I built a brand around all of those things that were bringing me money at that time. People knew me as the girl who was building websites. People knew me as the social media management girl. People knew me as the one that was doing a hangout. Then I used to do hangouts, okay?
Yeah.
So, So, but now, yeah, social media management, no day again. Hangouts, no day again. Other things, you don't go. But do you know the name Joy Negalu? Yes. If they ask you about her now, you say she has evolved. This was who I knew her as before, but now this is who she is. So that is my own formula to it. Follow the trend, you know, calm down. You need to eat. You need to look good. If you are hungry and you're a personal brand, nobody's going to answer you. Okay? So at least feed yourself, look good, you know. I know all those other small things. Then, by the time you do it and you feel like you have enough money to now do what you're passionate about, then you can now evolve. You will always evolve. All the people that you're seeing doing what they're doing now, they did not start from it. Okay, so many of them started from small things and then build to this point, okay? So don't bother your head about it. Get the money. As long as you're offering value the right way, get the money, you know, and then keep looking towards that thing that you're passionate about. That's it.
Amazing. That's just apt and straight to the point. So the next question is, right now, several serious, in quotes, minded people are thinking of going global, like global. It's enough to build a personal brand, but we don't want to limit ourselves to Nigeria. So as an expert in branding strategies, personal branding, how can one go global as a personal brand?
So let's not even get it twisted, okay? The concept of global personal branding, I don't want to call it a myth, okay? So like I said, it all depends on your positioning. So many people position themselves the wrong way. It all depends on your positioning, okay? So, for example, now, there are little things that can make people perceive you as someone who is below the ladder, and there are things that can make people perceive you as someone who is up there, all right? First of all, what brand do you attach yourself with? What brand, okay? There are reasons people do not do speaking engagements for any kind of person. There's a reason. It's not because they're too proud. No, they're not too proud. It is being strategic. If HP call me, I will talk to a global speaker, B. It's you that is disturbing yourself, that is, it's you that is giving the title, global speaker, right? So for me, it's a positioning thing. The moment maybe you go to US now and your friend says, Blessing, I have a hangout, please. I would like you to speak to my people and all of this thing. You speak there. But nothing you start speaking is global
international speaker.
international speaker. So it's not even a question of the environment. No. It is Tony Robbins has never been, I don't think Tony Robbins has come to Nigeria. Or Gary Vee has come to Nigeria to speak to anybody. No. You know? But how do we know about them? Positioning. Number two, the whole attention hacking. Like I said, attention hacking. How do you deliver your message? All right? How do you say what you say? Then media. See, you exactly, or even Cotonou, the other international speaker, my sister Liza. It's true. It's true, okay? So, media. How do you work with the media? See, guys. It is, even if it means you paying for an interview or a place in the newspaper on TV, go for it. Go for it, okay? From next year, I'm actually planning like a mastermind where we intend to offer these things to our clients. Because, I mean, I have these media people, so why not do the needful, right? So some people are doing amazingly well. They just need like one tweak here and there, okay? Mm-hmm. It is money for ads that you have. Run the ads. Let me give you an example. How many of us were on YouTube for the last 3-4 months, and then anytime you're watching a YouTube video, you see that you're watching the video and you've been doing it the absolute wrong way. How many of us have been watching that guy on YouTube? Attention
hallelujah.
Hacking, oh. Exactly. Attention hacking. And he kept on doing that advert until people started talking about him. Mind you, that guy, that is not the first time that guy is going viral. The first time he went viral was where he was trying to dance with a white girl and the girl ran away when he told the girl that he was Nigerian. The girl ran away. So the guy actually knows, he knows how to get people's attention. Guys, we need to begin to learn these things. And that is why you need money. You need kudi. You need money in your pocket because you're not gonna tell YouTube, please do the ad. I will pay you later. No, you have to drop the money there. Okay. So the guy. Okay, so everybody saying they know him. They know him. Okay. So he does not. I'm sure he does not even know. But we all know him already. Personal branding, guys. So
yeah.
Being a global personal brand has nothing to do with the environment. It has absolutely nothing to do with the environment. Association, attention hacking, media, all of these things play a hook. And then even the way you package your product and the experiences people get from it. Okay, so for example, I'm going to be with the Tony Robbins program. If there's any of his programs, I know so much that people are always like, wow, wow, wow. Even when I'm listening to other authors, when I'm listening to their audiobooks, right, they always refer to that particular program. That one where he had people like Oprah Winfrey work on a hot coal, you know. He had Donald Trump, too. And I think the owner of the Learning Annex, he had the guy to work on that hot coal. Now, if he has poured hot coal for these people, right, they wouldn't have gone on it, okay? But the whole experience put together, it was so, even if you're putting your products together, please, okay, ensure that you package it in a very premium way, okay?
Yeah.
Very, very important. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Joy, for that. Thank you so much for everything, because I really lack words right now to express how I feel and how grateful I am. So thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for the insight you shared during this session. Sadly, we need to go because we have just 1 minute more. So guys, if you want to reach out to Joy, just search for her on Instagram, Joy Enehalu. If you haven't followed us, please follow us. We have one more session coming up next week with Victoria Wanda. Yes, she's coming up next week to talk about how we can leverage on digital technology for personal development. So follow us and come back next week, Saturday, same time, same platform. Also follow Joy Enehalu. For those who are asking if we are going to replay will be available. So once you are done, if you joined in late, I suggest that you go back and watch the replay from the beginning, because that's even where the core things is. So thank you so much, everyone. See you next week, same platform, same time. For now, from us to you is bye. Bye.